Para mi gente, chequealo, Bushwick on my mind. Quinceañeras at the bodega with their pretty pink dresses, luscious dark eyes longing to cut the Valencia cakes, while Mr. Softy lingers over coco helados y piragueros fighting for the last dollar. Across the street, santeros dressed in white with their collares buying chickens at the poultry shop for their next tambor to be held this Sunday in someone else's crowded basement. Maggie cruising back and forth, keeping the dealers in check as the sound of beepers, Rottweiler fights, freestyle, and chanting from the Pentecostal church fill the air with the smells of pernil, alcapurrias, y empanadas from La Claribel, the best cuchifrito in town. Up on the roof, Miguelito giving blowjobs to gray-haired old men so that he can get a fade at Paul's boutique or buy mommy that fake painting she wanted for $5.99 down Knickerbocker Avenue. Melissa walking by, pregnant with her second baby, only 18 and already night manager at McDonald's. She wasn't gonna end up consumed in the empty little crack bags she counted every morning on her way to Grover Cleveland High School. Hector, her boyfriend, home from playing handball all day, lying shirtless on the couch, blunted out of his mind, staring at the roach on the ceiling. One single roach in a vast desert, or maybe an alien exploring a new world, the ceiling fan, his spaceship. Doña Carmen sneezing so loud, the walls so thin, Hector says salud, and she hears him from the second floor of a Huarte Mercado on Canal 41, turning off the kitchen lights so that the roaches can scurry into the darkness, their freedom like the children playing out all night, waiting for the L train. Mira, Georgie, give me a quarter. Fine, but you better pay me back tomorrow. Life in Bushwick, ain't it a trip? One day we'll all be buried beneath the ground we spit on.